Hello and welcome to InstaBlog's Global Report. This is my newest fresh update and more citizen voices from all over the world. Stories for the day are: the men's walk to see first female football game in West Bank. Mexico launches friend congresswoman and friend congressman program to welcome Mexican nationals living abroad on Christmas and New Year. And thousands evicted from our forests as Kenyan government moves to protect the water top. Football matches are always a big deal in the West Bank, but this game is more significant than most. More than 10,000 women flocked the national stadium to see the Palestinian women's national team playing Jordan in their first ever home international. CJ Wazirik expresses her excitement from neighboring Jordan.
This is Wag Wazirik, reporting for the InstaBlog from Jordan. In an experience that is considered new in the Palestinian society, around 10,000 women gathered in a football stadium on the outskirts of East Jerusalem to watch a football match played between the Palestinian female team against the Jordanian team. This match is considered one of its kind, as societal norms still consider this game a male game, causing some kind of difficulty in convincing families of letting their daughters join in the new football team, as explained by Hani Khaljiye, the team's 25-year-old captain. The game ended with both teams scoring 2 goals, but for the watching crowd, the result was not as important as the message sent out by the match itself. Palestinians can fight for what they want and will achieve whatever goals they set their eyes on.
The Chamber of Deputies of Mexico has launched the Friend Congresswoman, Friend Congressman program to welcome Mexican nationals living abroad to return for Christmas and New Year holidays. A figure from Mexico wonders whether a similar program offering the same benefits and security could be put in place to 110 million people living within Mexico.
The Chamber of Deputies of Mexico has launched a program to welcome Mexican nationals living abroad to return for the Christmas and New Year's holidays. Leticia Salazar, President of the Population, Borders and Migratory Issues of the Chamber of Deputies, said on Sunday that this program is aimed at preventing blackmail and abuses against the over 900,000 migrants who return home annually for the holidays. The Paisano program will also aid in supervising and avoiding violations of the human rights of Mexican nationals living abroad, adding that many migrants complained that they were blackmailed and mistreated when returning home. Salazar, a member of the ruling party PAN, stated the idea of the program is to welcome migrant Mexicans back to Mexico to visit their relatives or return for residence. The program aimed at 900,000 Mexican migrants sounds promising. Now, if they'd only developed one offering the same benefits and security to the over 110 million Mexicans who never moved abroad.
Kenyan government has decided to implement forced relocation of illegal settlers in country's Mau Forest due to rising environmental concerns. Together, Wanguri supports eviction meant to protect the endangered forest.
This is Rose Wanguri, a citizen journalist from Kenya, reporting on InstaBlog. Mau Forest is one of the Kenya's water towers, but has now turned into a political gold mine as the government implements an eviction exercise of illegal settlers who had turned the forest into farming land. Even though political leaders from the region have turned the government unfair by evicting the people who claim to have no alternative land to go to, the occupants have no documents to support the occupation of the forest land. Prime Minister has found himself on a hot spot as he is the one spearheading the evictions and attracted enmity from powerful ethnic Kalenjin politicians from whose community most of the occupants come from. Kenya Forest Tower has witnessed a downward trend, massively decreasing from 12% some years back to a mere less than 2% now due to illegal human encroachment. Politics aside, Mau, which feeds Lake Victoria and the White Nile, needs to be jealously guarded as important water source. Despite, we would not have any good reason whining over climate change if we cannot even protect what we have at the moment.
If you want your voice to be heard by your link, that InstaBlogs for your choice, you can contact us at cj@instablogs.com. That's all for today's show. We'll be back with fresh updates and more citizen voices. Till then, it's goodbye from the entire team of Global Report.